today people say that there is some division, there's space between, because of the way Bush, the president, began to move in his second term.
I don't see that, and
that
I think that's...
Dick Cheney had less influence, and by the end, when he was lobbying hard for a pardon for Scooter Libby, that was the final straw.
No, it's not. Look, that's not true. The men are
There was a great division and anger on Cheney's part about that.
Well, there's a
there's a
I wouldn't characterize it in the way that you did, but there was a he made a serious case for it, and he had strong feelings about it. But the men are very close personally and remain so to the end. And Cheney, my view is Cheney was influential throughout. Didn't mean that he won the arguments. It didn't mean that he was in charge by any stretch of the imagination, but the president chose him for a reason, and that he respected his judgment, his cast of mind, and felt that if anything were to happen to him, Cheney was the person who could best reassure the country that it had strong leadership. So Cheney remained influential right from the, he was influential at the beginning and influential right to the end. So I don't see
but
that.
But there
division.
Were times that the president rejected his advice or recommendation.
And as he did mine, and as he did Connie's, as he did Andy Card's, as he did Josh Bolton. I mean, at the end of the day, one of the things, and then my purpose in putting that in there was to show, look, Bush didn't keep me around because of my pretty face. He didn't keep me around because of my athletic abilities to be able to go bike riding.
He kept you around because?
He kept me around because, like a lot of the people around him, I was willing to say, Mr. President, or in this case, Governor, here's what I believe. And it's different than what you think.
Join us online at charlierose.com.